Good day, viewers. Welcome to Afris Concept TV, your number one reliable channel, where you get updated and enlightened on what is happening around you. I appreciate you for the time spent while watching and viewing our channel. So if you are new on this channel, don't forget to click on the subscribe button as well as the bell button to get updated whenever I drop any video.
Breaking news. The Supreme Court adjourns Imo governorship review. The Supreme Court has adjourned the review of the Imo governorship election till Tuesday 3rd, 2020. Emeka Ihedioha of the PDP had requested the Supreme Court review the 14th January 2020 judgment that removed him as Imo state governor and installed Hope Uzodinma of the APC as his replacement. The People's Democratic Party's Emeka Ihedioha is by his application filed on February 5, 2020, seeking the review of the Appeals Court February 13, 2020 judgment, which removed him from office after 7 months of being inaugurated as Imo State Governor. The Appeals Court is the disputed victim, which Ihedioha alleged was obtained by fraud, installed the APC Hope Uzodinma as Ihedioha's replacement. The judgment reviewed application was on February 18th adjourned till Monday for hearing, but a 7-man panel of the court led by the Chief Justice of Nigeria, Justice Tanko Muhammad, however, further adjourned the application till Tuesday following a request by Ihedioha's lawyer, Chief Kanu Agabi. Agabi said that the matter was adjourned till today for hearing, but incidentally, we were served a process by the respondents in the court this morning, which we must look at in order to respond. The matter was adjourned for the hearing, and just a few moments ago, we were served with a process, and we will have to look at it. If it's convenient for us to come back tomorrow or not, he said. On his part, Damian Dodo, counsel to Uzodinma, said they were ready to proceed with the hearing. The applicants were served with the process this morning because they filed on Friday. Today is the earliest we could fill. We are prepared to proceed, he said. After consulting the 7-man panel of justice led by Abraham Tanko, Chief Justice of Nigeria, adjourned the case finally. The Supreme Court, after computing with the excluded votes in the 388 post unit, came to the conclusion that Uzodinma and APC scored majority of lawful votes in the March 9, 2019 governorship election in the state. In the unanimous judgment delivered by Justice Kudirat Kekere-Ekpo, the appeal court ordered that the certificate of return issued to Ihedioha be withdrawn and a new one be issued by INEC to Uzodinma. However, dissatisfied with the appeals court decision, Ihedioha, through his counsel, returned to the same court with a request that the judgment be reviewed and judgment set aside. According to the justice, he said that the adjournment was due to the fact that some senior lawyers involved in the case were just served today. According to them, it will be fair if adequate time is given to them to be able to study the brief in order to be able to defend their client properly in court. Court section will reconvene on Tuesday morning to examine the governorship election matter between all the Progressive Congress and the People's Democratic Party and their candidates, Hope Uzodinma and Emeka Ihedioha, respectively. Dissatisfied with the verdict of the appeal court, Ihedioha, through its legal team, approached the Supreme Court in a motion on notice dated February 5, 2020, seeking to nullify the judgment delivered by the court on January 14, 2020. Ihedioha contended that the judgment sought to be set aside in a nullity in
in that it was delivered without jurisdiction by reason of the following. Having regard to section 142 of the Electoral Act, the appellant respondent divested this court of the relevant jurisdiction to deliver the first appellant as the winner of the gubernatorial election conducted in Imo State on March 9, 2019 by branding or stigmatizing the entire election as invalid. EADOR and PDP add that the appeal court did not have the jurisdiction to declare that Uzodinma was duly elected in the absence of any proof that the vote ascribed to him meets the mandatory geographical spread stipulated in section 179(2) of the Constitution. NAN reports that Uzodinma, in a preliminary objection dated February 5th, asked the Supreme Court to dismiss the application filed by EADOR. Uzodinma prayed that the Supreme Court for an order setting aside as a nullity that the judgment delivered by it should be on January 14, 2020. Uzodinma and APC's preliminary objection against EADOR was brought pursuant to Section 6 of the 1999 Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria as amended. The objection raised and urged the competence of the motion and the jurisdiction of the court to entertain same, and therefore urged the appeal court to strike out the motion filed by EADOR. They said that the application, being a proceeding relating to or arising from election of the governor, is barred by expiration of time. The application constitutes an invitation to the Supreme Court to sit on appeal over its final decision. They submitted that, having delivered its final decision, the Supreme Court has become functus and divested of jurisdiction over the same subject matter. They said Order 8 Rule 16 of the Supreme Court Rule 2014 prohibits the apex court from reviewing its judgment once again and delivered, save to correct clerical mistakes or accidental clips.
Wow, as if I knew. I had it in mind that it's going to be adjourned, and now it has been adjourned. Why can't they just conclude this matter once and for all, instead of adjourning this case all over and over again?
This date is immaterial. We will all wait till Tuesday. So that is tomorrow, 3rd of March 2020. Most people in Nigeria are no mathematicians, mostly when it comes to Imo election. I think it's only God that can grant EADOR victory over Hope Uzodinma. One thing is sure, that the judges are no longer comfortable with their early judgment, but to reserve it is another big blow on the reputation of the appeals court itself. So on Tuesday is 3rd and not 2nd. We are all waiting for justice. It's only Supreme God that can make mistake, so don't put yourself in position of God. The whole world are watching Nigerians, and tomorrow's adjournment, we'll pray it brings positive results. In this judgment, God is the final say, as far as I'm concerned. No matter how he had the judiciary try, the earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof. So, let's all wait till tomorrow and know what tomorrow we hold for this man, Emeka Nwediha. That
That is what I have to say concerning this news. So viewers, what is your take on this? If you have any comments or any contributions at all, don't hesitate to drop them below the comment box. Click on the subscription button as well as the bell button to receive updates whenever I publish any new video. Or also don't forget to like this news and share this news as well.